last meeting. Anybody want to make a motion to approve?
So moved.
Second?
Yep.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Okay, our meeting, minutes from last meeting are approved. Now, I guess we'll just move right on to the first order of business.
Well, three of you are familiar with this. Jean didn't get to see this part last year. It's not a whole lot of change from last year. It's just the typical government forms, so nothing changes from year to year. But the idea is kind of, like I said, still the same. I believe you should have a map of the area that we're talking about.
Yeah.
Hopefully everybody has all covered. The red outline on that map is the historic district as we know it today. Even on this map, if you look close enough, you can see there's a number of places where there's nothing. It's been tore down since the survey that was done in 1983. So that may be areas where it's removed from the district. There's other areas like City Hall, for instance, that for whatever reason was not placed on the register then, but are certainly eligible. There'll be maybe some stuff to this building that doesn't quite meet the historic stuff, but the building itself certainly is still considered historic, at least the front portion of it. And then there's some other places that anything in green that's outside of the red, of course, is, this is just me, thoughts about adding it to a survey. But basically the idea of the survey would be to look at everything. If you've seen our existing survey, most of the listings are pretty simple. It has stuff like when they thought it was built, if they had the information, who built it, who the designer was, and what the use was at that time, the owner was at that time, and that's pretty much it. Now the State Historic Society has a nice setup now that we would use on a new survey called the Kansas Historic Resources Inventory, or KHRI, and it has some newer stuff on it, primarily more pictures. Back in 2009, I think it was, the SHPO came down and took a lot of pictures of some of the buildings and tried to match them up with the current listings, so it's certainly better than what was there in 1983.
Yeah.
This survey, of course, would add to that and would hopefully get some more of the like architects, designers, builders, that kind of stuff should be put in there, and more history, especially on the buildings that weren't actually on the survey. I was surprised to find no evidence of anything being surveyed that was not included in the district. Like City Hall, for instance.
Mm-hmm.
There's no rhyme or reason as to why it wasn't included unless the city just decided to exclude it. I don't know, that maybe that's all it was. But it would have been in the 60-year-old range at that time, this current building.
Mm-hmm.
So it would have been helpful. But now it certainly is well beyond that, into the 90s. So some of these numbers, pretty much, I just threw in some estimates. It needs to be updated because my time's a little more valuable than it was this time last year, so we may squeeze in some other stuff. And I think I may bump the consultant up to 14,000 just to be safe. But what I did was went to several different possibilities for consultants and said, hey, how much would you charge? I'm applying for a grant, so I don't need hard numbers, but I want to have an idea. Most of them said anywhere in the $75 to $100 range per building. And so doing some quick math, that came up to somewhere in the neighborhood of 13,000. And like, I just added on, I'm thinking 14 just to be safe for the sake of the nice thing is, the match that's required for this grant doesn't have to be cash. The majority of it is my time and your time. So that's kind of nice. So I guess the main thing I was going to ask you for is some input onto what we should include in the project. Do we want to just leave it like that? I know Gene has mentioned in the past, maybe talk about housing or something like that. But it'd be something that we would talk to the consultant about when they interviewed him, I guess. Of all the different things we can include in it. For that price, I guess.
Well, if we're going to get involved in something like this, the idea of simply cataloging what we have really doesn't give us anything to work with.
Right,
so
it does not, this project would not add anything or subtract anything to the registers. It just gives us the information so that we can do those things.
Right. But then going back to my original premise, at least, is that residences downtown are could very well drive what downtown Arc City will become. And so I'd be interested in talking to your consultants to see what it would take to actually inventory these buildings, determine what the square footage is, especially that is already designed, it was designed as living space. Now there's no point in going on the top floors of the Newman building to determine that they were sales floors. But nearly every building downtown has at least one floor that was living space. A lot of them had two. I mean, it's thousands and thousands of square feet. And most of the configurations are still there.
Right.
So,
and just minor changes, and that's about it.
Yeah, but anyway, out of that then, that if we could determine what it would take to actually survey that part of it, but then also figure out what the impact on the owners it would be in making those determinations. Because I can just imagine people just screwing themselves into the ceiling if somebody walked in there with a tape measure and a camera and wanted to go through their building without being set up properly.
Right.
Yeah. You'd have to make contact. And really, as part of this process, I think we would attempt to make contact with everybody anyways. Just to let them know, hey, this is what we're doing. Even if we're only on the outside, they're going to be like, why are you measuring the building?
Absolutely.
Why are you figuring out the building? So we'll, and of course, part of this too, in fact, it's pretty much a requirement for the grant, is we have to have, I think it's at least two public meetings to bring some people in to say, hey, this is what we're doing. Don't be too scared by it, because all it is, we're just trying to find more information about what we have. Because so many of them maybe don't have a clue. They just think, I own an old building. There's more to it. There's some history there. Maybe a famous Arc City and once was in there and you had interesting businesses in there that you didn't know about. So even the project that Kevin mentioned, they found some interesting facts about buildings, and in fact some of the information was actually incorrect.
Yes. Yeah, well, one building in particular I was working on as a student, the old Oddfellows Hall, which is now the college's, exercise facility there. The date that I think the original 83 thing was not right. It was not built when they said it was built.
So that was pretty easy to find out that information.
Well, this is middle school students doing research on the internet found out the right answer. I mean,
the power of the internet. 1983, there was not much of it.
That's right. They didn't have an internet to check these things. So.
Yeah, Al Gore hadn't discovered it.
Yeah. Or invented it. So, really, that's what I was coming here before. I know this is kind of a light agenda. But I kind of wanted your feedback, and I wanted to
agenda,
get your support.
It's a light agenda, but I think it's an important agenda of what we're doing here.
So we're just updating, is that what we're doing? Kind of.
Yeah, I mean, obviously we didn't actually apply for that grant last year, so as far as the write-up is concerned, I didn't change much. There is a timeline in here, but it's modeled after another application, another city's application. And that one would hope to have the entire thing done and reimbursement requests and all that kind of good stuff in April of 2018. It may go faster than that, I don't know. We could only find that information out when we actually get somebody on site and they actually start their preliminary work and say, hey, this is going to take X number of months, or this is way too ambitious, we're not going to make it by the... However, I think that we have to have it done by, it's either the end of 2018 or the end of the fiscal year. So it might be just, it might be in September, the federal fiscal year. It might have to be done by then, but it should be on this timeline. We'll have it.
And the attempt to do this last year stopped with the commission, is that right?
Yes, they said no.
Yeah, I took it too late to them, really, is what it came down to. And it was a 2-2 vote.
Yeah.
So it wasn't necessarily a denial, but I couldn't go to another meeting to try to get that fifth commissioner to vote on it because we ran out of time. So this time, if we go that route, and we haven't quite decided how we're going to get the letter of support yet. But if we were to go that same route, then we'd do it earlier. And if they wanted to table it for a second meeting, then we still have time to do it, that kind of stuff. We learn as we go. And of course, as the commission changes, sometimes that's different. Sometimes I've had commissions that just rubber stamp almost everything I bring to them. And I've had other ones that question every single thing you do. This one's kind of a...
I think their concern was that the matching fund, that they would have to come up with cash, I think was what really concerned those that voted against it.
Well, and see, the thing too is technically they do have to come up with cash in the first year. It depends how the consultant wants to be paid. Mm-hmm. Because the reimbursement doesn't come until the end of the grant. So
yeah.
They're probably a little bit of cash up front. But that's something that we as city staff will work through, and city manager's pretty good about finding.
I assume since we're talking about this, that Nick's on board with doing it.
He seems pretty much, wouldn't you say, from the conversations we've had with him. He seemed pretty on board with it last year, too, actually. It's free money. Sort of.
Well, it could be very valuable, too, like you said, is they can do a survey and find out potential economic development in downtown as well as the historical part of it. I'd say that's pretty cheap.
Well, we have a lot of people sitting on buildings downtown that are really in no position doing anything with them themselves. Mm-hmm. They're owning buildings for practically nothing. They're worth a great deal more than they have in them, but they aren't worth what they need to be for them to pony up the $1 million to redo them.
Themselves.
So anything at all that we can do to develop access to financing and that sort of thing would be a real boon, I would think.
And the more information they have, the better off they'll be, not just for historic tax credits and historic grants, but if you can document to a regular banker, hey, this is what it's really supposed to look like, they may be willing to pony up a little bit extra money on the loan, too. So it'll help.
Yeah, the tax credit thing, it's a nightmare to get involved in that. But through the Burford project, which we're now within about 700,000 of having it finished, but my wife has filed for the tax credits on it through development to this point, and apparently they're all going to be paid, and it will generate $1.5 million.
Yeah.
And that $1.5 million will go into a self-sustaining fund to keep the theater operational. So won't build anything out of it, it's just making sure that the thing can operate.
Yeah,
there's a whole lot of money out there.
It's out there, because I remember years ago we talked about, because City Hall was not in the historic district, they didn't take advantage of a tax credit they could have used when they put the roof on here.
Yeah, why that,
and you say, well, why you, you know, cities,
like
cities can't use tax credits. Well, cities can use tax credits. They can resell them on an open market and get cash for that. Even
what
though
they
they're
can't
not.
Use is the federal ones.
Yeah.
The federal
right.
ones, you do have to be an income producer
right.
to get them. But a lot of the downtown is owned by income producing businesses.
Yes.
So they can. Of course, it's a little more stringent than the state one, too, just that much more.
So you're looking for a motion to proceed?
Well, I still have some questions. Like, is this survey just gonna survey the old survey, or are they gonna survey the whole downtown area, or how?
The numbers that I threw at them was pretty much all the properties that are in green.
Okay.
So, and
so it's the existing one plus a lot of additional
bonus ones, yeah. Because I think it's important to even the vacant lots.
Uh-huh.
If they're in this current survey, we need to figure out if they need to stay there.
Yeah.
Now, we don't necessarily need to take them off. That's the kind of recommendations you get from
mm-hmm.
a project like this.
Right.
Is whether you should. Generally, the state kind of frowns upon taking stuff off, but if
right.
it doesn't make any sense,
yeah.
like this one that's in the parking lot today of the Brown Center,
yes.
that's never going to
where Rainy Davis used to
and the Brown Center isn't historic either.
No, not yet, no.
So.
But Scott Auditorium is.
Yeah. And for some reason that one is not.
Yeah, and Ireland Hall is. And then as you just go up the street a little bit, you got the Congregational Church that could also be. But that's another question I have. Does everything have to be contiguous? Because, you know, we have some things in town here, like the...
It does for a district.
For a district, okay.
But you could survey anyways and get it on the register if it's
mm-hmm.
not on the register.
Like
I think we probably have some buildings that
are rotunda. Obviously
yeah.
could be
rotunda would be a good example of
one.
And actually the train could be too.
Yeah.
It's been there long enough.
Well, there's actually some merit in keeping those vacant lots in it.
Mm-hmm.
And that is so you maintain some control over what gets built on it.
Well, that's true.
Well, we have, I was going to kind of wait for this later, but there is a proposal for the lot across from the old corner bank. RCB wants to put an ATM in there. I'm waiting for them to give me more details, but I did say you're going to have to go through the review process. And then what we would do, I asked the state for guidance, and basically we just look to make sure whatever they're going to put in there doesn't
is that
detract from the neighboring building.
Yeah.
Is that where the Elmo was?
No, the other
no,
corner.
No,
the other corner, okay.
Where the radiator was.
That's that building that burnt, wasn't it? On that corner.
I'm
there was
sure
a service station in there.
Service station. That's what it was.
Yeah, there were two things in there. There's also a dry cleaner.
Dry cleaner.
The old Osage
mm-hmm.
cleaners was there. I think both of that building had burned some years back.
I did just a small amount of research on that when
it
first came in and found the photo of when the buildings were, both of them are still there. I'm still waiting on them. I don't know if the bank's quite figured out what they're doing. They may be trying to finish up their remodeling project before they proceed to.
Right. Another question I had about, you know, are the boards in kind? You know what we would do. What exactly would that entail? I mean, what could we do that would be in kind work?
Some of it would be mostly just reviewing everything,
mm-hmm.
and towards the end of the project, I'm sure that if the consultant was open to it, there could be some assistance in that part of it too, to try to generate more hours.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, the way we calculate it is minimum wage.
Yeah,
that's how we calculate.
Since it's volunteer anyway. So.
No, we're not gonna pay you.
Okay.
And then mine is whatever my current salary is.
Right.
But yeah, there's not a whole lot of the stuff that would happen. What did I put down? I said 40 hours.
Yeah.
that would be, with four, it'd be 10 hours
mm-hmm.
apiece. And of course, with the fifth one, it would be just a little bit less than that. So that's several meetings, is where I calculated that. That may be a little too generous,
yeah.
to be honest, but it depends what all is done.
Well, we can discuss this further with a motion on the floor, so I'll make a motion that we proceed with the grant application.
Okay, do we have a second?
A second.
There's no more discussion, right? No more questions before we...
Well, I think there's a lot of questions, we just haven't got to them yet.
Well, yeah,
when the guy gets
right.
here.
Yeah, unfortunately, we don't
some of the information
that
Josh comes back with.
Right. I think you're right about that, yeah.
And
okay.
I can still send this out for preliminary review.
Mm-hmm.
Next couple weeks.
Okay, we have a second. All those in favor of proceeding with this grant application, say aye.
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 Unanimous. Approved. Okay. I don't think we have any other business, do we?
We did have some minor stuff.
Okay.
Andrew has something in a second.
Okay.
I was going to talk about the ATM, but we already talked about that.
Huh?
And the library windows, they've kind of been pushing a little bit harder for that. They're wanting to put vinyl windows in, so
mm-hmm.
I said, back up a little bit.
mm-hmm.
And try to, I told her aluminum windows would probably be cheaper than vinyl, or not vinyl, cheaper than wood.
Yeah.
So maybe look at those, and then I encouraged them to look into the grants and the credits
mm-hmm.
too. So we'll see where that goes.
See where that goes, yeah. Because if they decide that they are going to put vinyl in, we'll have to vote no, and then I imagine the city commission will overturn our decision. That's usually how that works.
Yeah.
But we'll be forced to say no.
Yeah, you guys wouldn't be able to approve it based
no,
on
we can't approve vinyl windows, no. Even if we personally feel like it's not anything wrong with it. We, by standards, have to say no.
But we have several examples where aluminum was used. The Burford used
yeah.
it.
Right.
No.
Oh, you didn't use aluminum?
No.
There would? Oh, okay.
No wood.
I must have made it. But there have been other projects in town that have used aluminum. You can make aluminum look like wood pretty well.
Yeah.
It's just vinyl that's incredibly difficult to make it look realistic. We know. Because we've had a few that went through that
right.
didn't turn out very well.
And the truth of the matter is, if you want to get an architectural redesign with vinyl, you can do it far better than you can do with aluminum.
Mm-hmm.
So there's, I think we ought to look at what people want to do, and I have no idea what the restrictions are, but we spent $90,000 putting windows up there. And we've already repainted them once. They need to be repainted again.
Mm-hmm.
It's just endless, absolutely
yeah,
freaking endless. And
right.
you know, you can use colored vinyls and specify weights and all kinds of things and come up with something you couldn't identify from the street as not being wood.
Right.
And why aluminum works, but vinyl doesn't.
Yeah.
Doesn't unless it's
mystery.
Just something somebody wrote.
Yeah, it's a great mystery.
One of the many regulations.
I'm trying to think if there's anything, any other projects that, I mean, obviously RCB approached me on the corner bank remodel. That's one of those weird ones that's not in the district. So, I'm like, okay, well, you can proceed because I don't have any, anything
well,
that stops you from
yeah.
doing
plus the building wouldn't.
It might not qualify. It
wouldn't qualify anyhow.
But it's not.
Wouldn't think.
It would be a non-participating building even though it wasn't there, yes.
But there's other buildings in that block.
Yeah.
That probably would be participating or contributing.
Yeah.
Andrew, you had
compared to how much we discussed, I know when we did the general provisions, it's only tied to revisions for this board, isn't it? The last set, so I know we talked about it, but this is the final version of the general provisions for all city boards. And really, I just need to check a box off on my list that I talked to you about it, so if anyone has any questions, it just goes over, how meetings are handled, how they're canceled, the officers, which you've already elected the vice chair. One thing I would ask you to do, if you don't mind, is just to formally designate Josh as your secretary, assuming that's who you want, that way we just have it on file. You don't even like to vote, just nod. You know, it talks about you can serve on one other board, which Gordon is doing as a planning commissioner. The way the vacancies are handled, and I think we may have talked about this a little, basically, the way we're gonna do it now is, to avoid any dispute or staff having to make judgments, we'll have a little form, so I guess it'll apply to George, but secretary notes the absence, it'll be the board chair's determination once excused or not in accordance with, section 254, subpoint B. Certain things are automatic, and then there's others that are just kind of a judgment, but the basic thing I've been communicating to boards is if a member informs Josh ahead of time, they're not gonna be here, and that to me is an excused absence. It's the people that don't show up, don't answer the calls, and just disappear on us that we need to work on getting replaced, so.
And by the way, George, I talked to him.
Yeah.
I know he wasn't gonna be here.
So, just a bit of a paper trail there, so it's not like staff ticking boxes and having disputes in the line. But other than that, and of course defining a quorum, the other basics, we took this all out of the different boards and just stuck it in one place. The one thing, other thing I mentioned under the budgeting section, we have been challenging some of our boards, if they're interested in doing more. It obviously takes money to do much of anything anymore. I think this commission is open to doling out some funding to the boards, but it will require having some proposal of what it is that you want to do. So not only having a budget, but having some tangible goals. And so several of our boards that are working right now on some strategic planning in that regard, they're going through their bylaws, looking at what it is that they're actually tasked with doing, and then trying to come up with some realistic goals. And then when we're done with that, we'll say, okay, what's that, you know, how much do you need to do such and such? And then make some presentations to the commission and see if they get it for 2018. You're sort of already doing that with the grant application, but there are other things I would encourage you to look at.
Well, and actually these grants can be used for a pretty wide array of things. So sometimes just a preservation plan, which is basically what you'd be looking for, that's your version of a strategic plan,
mm-hmm.
would be eligible for grant funding. So that's an option, however detailed you want it to be.
Yeah, I mean, it's up to you guys. It's just something to think about, you know, if you want to have those meetings to talk about those kind of issues. There's obviously some time, although staff's trying to push the budget through a little faster than years past. We'll see if that actually works out. Concurrently, you know, we have the CIP committee that we're getting together. And I don't know if any of you have filled out the form, but I encourage you, if you're interested in that, I think your perspective is a good one to have on those kinds of things, or planning commissions. People who are already putting their time in and with a planning perspective, as opposed to, we'll get some other citizens that haven't been involved, that was the goal. But they're planning out the capital improvement projects, not just for the 2018 budget, but really the next 10 years. And the big one on that, I think, will be streets. You know, once we use up all the sales tax money, we'll go back to some down to maintenance. So what are we gonna do as the next big push, and how are we gonna fund it? Is something I think that committee will be talking about. And I know you're gonna start going through the master plan, so the comprehensive plan.
Yeah, we'll probably start
section.
Work on that too.
And so the time will come to revisit the historical preservation aspects of that. I'm sure. So there's a lot of planning things going on. We're also working on a traffic safety committee. So I think it's a good time for all the boards to kind of step back and look at their mission and come up with some strategic goals that are all going to filter into that
thing we've really been neglected on is reviewing the comp plan. That's supposed to happen every year and it don't.
Yeah.
It doesn't.
That is true. I think Josh's plan is to kind of go through section by section here over the next year and then look at another big rewrite in probably about 2020. That's kind of what we talked about. That would be about 7 years since the last one.
Yeah, we may attempt to do quite a bit of it in-house this time because we have a good base now.
Well, you know, we went through about a year-long project getting that thing done. Mm-hmm. Then we just put it back on the shelf and forget it.
That's not completely forgotten. I review it.
We do look at it.
Yeah.
You know, I think part of it was so arduous, you just want to take a break. I think part of it is we're working on a staff, some technical backbone stuff like that, so that it's not so difficult. I mean, you were with us, we looked at that planning system for regulations and such, but you know, surveying, things like that are always difficult, they're always expensive, they're always time consuming. But what I'm hoping the CIP will do is kind of give us small reads on the community input, and as opposed to having to go every 5 to 10 years, do a big sweeping survey that costs lots of money, trying to get that input on a more regular basis so we kind of already have a sense of it, and then we don't have to put all that effort into a big planning process. Rather, it would be more of just pulling in what we've been gathering and then stepping back and looking at the big picture. So that's one reason that I've been pushing the CIP committee pretty hard since I got here, because I mean, that's not everything in your comp plan, but it's most of the things. It's gonna hit most aspects of where you're growing your city, and that includes land use. So hopefully this is a good process. I think this first year it'll take a while to kind of get up and running, but if we keep doing it and citizens keep seeing some benefit from it, hopefully more people will turn in those forms and we'll start to get that feedback in-house and not have to go hire a consultant to do it.
Okay, we went through a process on the down on South 6th Street. Is that progressing any?
Oh, you're talking about the housing?
Mm-hmm.
It's been rezoned, so at this point we're just waiting to hear from them if they get the tax credits. And that would trigger the next step in the process.
Well, I've talked to a few people and they think it's a good idea what we've done.
Yeah, I think as of the last commission meeting, the few holdouts, or if not coming around to it, at least their concerns were becoming more mollified just from hearing more details on the process. And, you know, it's not like we're breaking ground tomorrow. So, so I think that feedback has died down a little bit, but it's in the hands of the state and whether or not they qualify for that project. I think they have a good chance at it, but there's also some changes that are probably going to be coming to housing and urban development. So
yeah, we don't know what will happen with new administration. It's our talent.
He appointed Ben Carson.
Wake him up and ask him something.
One other thing I want to mention, we're planning a board banquet on March 27th. That's a Monday night at the Wright Room. So we'll be mailing out invitations. It's a plus one event, and I would urge you to consider going if you can, because that will probably be the first time we publicly roll out the Wilson Park Master Plan. So,
what was the date again?
March
27th.
7th?
Yeah. 27th.
It's the week after spring.
27th, yeah.
Just something to show our appreciation for all the time that you guys put in and sacrifices you make coming to night meetings. It's been a while since we've gotten one of these, so I kind of want to do the big thing.
That'd be good.
So you'll get the first look at it, and I know Nick kind of wants to challenge the boards to think about how they can help advance that plan. And then I think we're going to show that chamber coffee later that week. And
put the rotunda on the register. That's how we'll advance that plan.
Except
that. Could change house design.
Oh, yeah.
We about lost that rotunda one night.
Mm-hmm.
What, the fire?
Mm-hmm.
Huh?
Yeah.
Fire.
Danger.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
been a lot of years ago, but man, it was really going.
Well, we've had, it's been more recent than that, though, the one that we had 5 or 6 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's been 25 years ago.
Well, this one was
I thought you were talking about the more recent. That was also a juvenile.